Now we have a little bit of time to quickly go through the time domain. And as I mentioned before, we're not focusing on the RR interval, but the NN interval, the normal rhythms that are associated with the SA nodes. And the four big ones that I want you to pay attention with, there are various others, but the ones that account for the majority of time domain measures in the literature out there are these four: the standard deviation of NN intervals, the standard deviation of 5-minute averages of the NN intervals, the root mean square of successives and intervals differences, and then PNN 50, which is the percentage of NN intervals that are greater than 50 milliseconds different than its prior NN intervals. And each of these sort of require a certain amount of time for the RMSSD, PNN 50. You could use up to 5 minutes. Some have used as little as 1 minute for RMSSD. For standard deviation of NN interval, NSDA and N, I think a lot of them have used 24 hours. And the clinical significance I will talk about a little bit later. So if you take a look at the NN interval over time, you can see a lot of this variability. And the two of the four time domain measures takes a look instead at the successive differences in the NN intervals. And it's basically difference between the RNN interval compared to the prior one. And this is how it looks like here. So if your heart rate was about 50 beats per minute on one time, and then it subsequently was, or let's just say it was 80 milliseconds for the first NN interval, then it was 90 seconds on the subsequent interval, then you have a 10 millisecond difference between the two. That's what they use in order to put out this time series. And you could see that this time series, it eliminates a lot of this slower dynamics that you see in the NN interval. And you see a lot of the faster process that occurs. And so RMSSD, which is the root mean squared of of this graph here, and PNN 50, which is the number of times that you have the successive differences go either above or below these thresholds, are an indication of these more rapid events, because you lose a lot of the slower components of your heart variability when you evaluate the successive differences in intervals. So when you're dealing with these measures, you're dealing with the faster components of your heart rhythm. And so you're talking about high frequency heart rate variability or the respiratory sympathetic arrhythmias, which we recall is largely a parasympathetic system, a phenomenon. So the question is, what are the physiological processes most correlated with SDNN, or the standard deviation of the NN interval? And the answer is, it really depends on the duration of the data. For 2 minutes, because we're doing predominantly with high frequency information or variability, the standard deviation SDNN reveals or represents much more RSA or parasympathetic nervous activity. For 5 minutes, you're invoking both the low frequency and high frequency components. So you have both the baroreflex and the RSA physiological processes within that signal. And then when you're talking about the 24-hour SDNN, it is predominated by much slower processes. And you can see that by the spectral power of each of these frequency ranges. You can see that high frequency, low frequency generally has lower power. And so for the lower frequencies, the very low and ultra low frequencies, they have a much higher power representation in this power spectrum. So when you're obtaining a 24-hour standard deviation, a lot of the variability is accounted by these slower rhythms. And so the SDNN of 24 hours represents these circadian or slower hormonal processes. So in summary, these two measures, which rely on the successive NN intervals, RMSSD, PNN 50, represent high frequency heart rate variability or respiratory sinus arrhythmia, and so indicates much more of a parasympathetic nervous activity. SDNN depends on the duration. The shorter that it is, it's more correlated with the higher frequency ranges. And then SDA and then here associates more with the circadian rhythm. So that is basically the end of the part one of this heart rate variability deep dive. And just to summarize, 1970s and 80s saw the major advances in heart rate variability physiology and measures. At rest, parasympathetic nervous tone normally is greater than the sympathetic nervous system tone. And heart rate variability frequency domain for each frequency range is associated with a specific physiological process. High frequency is associated with RSA or the parasympathetic nervous system. Lower frequency is associated with baroreflex and vasomotor, which have both a parasympathetic and a sympathetic component. And the ultra low frequency deals with hormone or circadian rhythms. And high frequency heart rate variability correlates with vagal parasympathetic nervous system, and the faster SNS activity is filtered out at the SA node. For the time domain measures, RMSSD and PNN50 correlate with high frequency, high heart rate variability, and therefore represented by the parasympathetic nervous system, and SDNN depends on the duration of the time series analysis. Now, because there's so much information here, there's probably going to be two or three more subsequent talks on heart rate variability. And some of the things that I'll talk about in the future will be the clinical studies, some of the physiological tests that are used to assess autonomic nervous system, nonlinear measures, and some of the applications of heart rate variability in psychological situations such as stress and sleep as well.